The San Joaquin County Sheriff's Office tonight asking for the public's help in identifying items in a serial killer case.
To try to get as much reach as possible for some of these cases and try to get closure for some of the families.
Nick Goucher with the San Joaquin County Sheriff's Office says they don't know who the item belongs to, but they really want to know. The pictures of an item released show a sandal, which is estimated to be size 4 or 4.5 in women, a horse pin, and on the back, the word star written, and
the stone in the setting. We're not sure exactly what that stone is. We're not sure what that setting, if it was part of a necklace or a ring, but it was just something that was found in amongst the rest of those items that might jog someone's memory.
And that is the hope, solving one cold case at a time. The San Joaquin County Sheriff's Office says these items pictured here were recovered from a well in this area near Linden back in 2012 and are believed to be related to the Speed Freak Killers case.
This was a big case spanning many locations, many years, many decades in some cases. So there's a lot to do. There's a lot of work still left to do.
The infamous case in San Joaquin County history, Lauren Herzog and Wesley Shermantine were dubbed the Speed Freak Killers because police say they were high on methamphetamine during their killing spree in the 1980s and 90s.
I know that there were more than 200 personal effects that were found in the well back in 2012.
Former State Senator Kathleen Galgiani has taken a prominent role in helping investigate the case and says a lot of the families have been waiting to see these personal belongings for decades.
Seeing a lot of cold cases be solved in the last several years, especially with advancements in DNA. And now that these photos are being released, if there's any doubt or any question, the family members and friends should reach out to the sheriff's department and ask to see a closer picture of the photo to possibly identify.
Galgiani hopes other law enforcement agencies in the area take notice as it could solve their cold case.
Wesley Shermantine was very clear that the time frame started in 83 or 84 and the killings didn't stop until 1998. There is information that's possibly missing. Now is really the time for family members to come forward and share what they know to make sure that law enforcement does have that information.